So you want to purchase a new tablet to replace your laptop with it, or maybe just for gaming and basic tasks. Whatever you need it for, I'm sure you want to buy the best tablet out there. So which one is the best? iPad Pro or Surface Pro? Which one is more pro? Hello everyone, if we are meeting for the first time, I am Nibs and I create videos to help you know more about how iPads are the future of computers. Please make sure to subscribe and click that notification bell so you won't miss any of my upcoming videos. And you can go and watch my previous videos if you are interested in learning about how iPads can be used as a daily driver instead of a laptop. When I launched my first video, I was skeptical of how well it will be received. I mean, most YouTubers out there are partially or completely against the idea of iPads replacing computers. But to my surprise, my video did well, and apparently many of you are interested in this subject and are thinking about switching to iPads instead of buying a new computer. And I do read all the comments I get, and I decided to make a new playlist, which is focused on your comments. So one of the first comments I got was, "Thank you, man, for this video. Actually, I am a big fan of Apple products and I have been using the iPhone since 2007. And I've been always thinking of replacing my Surface Pro with iPad Pro. I knew many people think about switching from laptops to iPads at some point or another, but a Surface owner? That grabbed my attention, since Microsoft tablets are the only devices that are close to the iPads in this market. So I decided that today I'm gonna be comparing the Surface Pro 8 with the 5th generation iPad Pro. Microsoft is really trying to close the gap in this competition, and they are pushing the boundaries to make a better tablet. You got the iPad, we have Surface 1 and 2 and 3. And why not push it even more? Let's make Pro and Pro 1, 2, 3, all the way up to Pro 8. And of course, Apple is not lazy as well, so they released Pro and they released Mini and iPad Air. Many models and many names, but is it just a battle of names? Or do we have a real competition? So let's compare the latest release of the tech giants. The Wi-Fi only 12.9 inch iPad Pro and the 13 inch Surface Pro, which so far doesn't support 4G or 5G. The Surface is thicker, heavier, and it has cooling fans, which is one major downside in my opinion. While iPad performs silently and can be more comfortable in many situations where you should be worried about ventilation in the Surface. On the iPad, you need to already know the amount of space you need because you can't change that later, while on the Surface, you can expand its SSD. That's a big thing for the Surface, right? Well, no. And here is why. The entry-level iPad Pro comes with Apple's amazing M1 chip and 128GB of SSD at the price of $1,100. The 256GB at the price of $1,200. The 512GB at $1,400. The 1TB at $1,800. And the 2TB at $2,200. And on the other hand, the Surface Pro 8 comes with Intel's Core i7 processor, 16GB of RAM and 256GB SSD at the price of $1,600. The 512GB at the price of $1,900. The 1TB at $2,200 and the 1TB with 32GB of RAM at $2,600. Did you see what just happened? The Surface Pro 8 1TB model is equal in price to the iPad Pro 2TB model. So the iPad Pro is cheaper at every configuration. Let's say you got the entry-level Surface Pro 8 with 256GB of SSD and you wanted to upgrade it to 1TB. That 1TB SSD will cost you $200 on top of the $1,600 you already paid, which is the same price of the 1TB iPad Pro in the first place. So in my opinion, the ability to expand the SSD in the Surface Pro is just pointless. And the only M2 type that is supported is much smaller, and the market for that SSD is much smaller as well. Let alone all the pain you will have to go through and all the steps you have to do before and after swapping that SSD, because you have to make a Windows recovery disk and you have to back up all your data, and then you have to restore the Windows version you had and then restore your data back again, and you don't need all that. The next thing you need to take into consideration is how much each of the operating systems is going to eat up of your space. iPadOS 15 takes up somewhere between 7 and 8 gigabytes of your SSD, while the Windows 11 will take up somewhere between 20 and 30 gigabytes. Of course, you can always archive your data to an external drive with both devices, And you can click on the card here to watch a previous episode where I talked about all you need to know about transferring data between iPads and external devices. Now let's talk displays. On both devices, the screen is great. They both support 120Hz, but the Surface has its settings defaulted to 60Hz to save battery life, so you will have to go into the settings and to change it manually into 120Hz. While on the iPad you have ProMotion, which will keep changing the range between 120Hz all the way down to 24Hz dynamically depending on what's showing on your screen. And now let's check the list of specs for each display. The Surface Pro 8 tops at 500 nits and up to 600 nits in HDR. And it has a 13-inch display with 3:2 aspect ratio with 2880 by 1920 pixel resolution at 267 ppi. While the iPad has 600 nits max brightness and 1000 nits max full screen brightness up to 1600 nits peak brightness in HDR. And the iPad packs a 12.9 inch touch display with a 4:3 aspect ratio and 2732 by 2048 pixels, resolution at 264 ppi, with ProMotion, True Tone, fingerprint resistance, and anti-reflective coating at 1.8% reflectivity. And it's a fully laminated display, which makes the iPad Pro display the best in terms of accuracy, contrast, and colors for the average user as well as professionals. Now the rest of features are all in the favor of the iPad. You have LiDAR sensors and dual cameras on the back for ultra-wide and short-range photos. You have center stage feature in the front camera, and both the back and the front camera are much better than the ones on the Surface. You have secure unlock, and you can purchase items with Face ID, while on the Surface you only have Windows Hello, which is only useful for logging in. The speakers on the iPad are higher in quality and they provide a loud and rich sound, but it lacks a headphone jack, while the Surface has a headphone jack. In terms of keyboards, the overall experience is much better with the Magic Keyboard than the Surface keyboard. You have a better build quality, you have key travel and better trackpad, and the floating iPad makes the scene much better. But you know me, I am a fan of the old iMac Bluetooth keyboard anyway, and you can watch the previous episode where I talked about the benefits and features of the best keyboard for the iPad. The Surface Pro 8 has two Thunderbolts while the iPad has one, so you might need to purchase a hub so you can connect all your accessories. Now we have to check the performance on both devices. So I pulled the highest score I could find on the Geek-bench mark for each device, and the results did not shock me at all. The iPad outperforms the Surface at almost every test in the single and multi-core test. And as you can see, only the green color numbers are in favor of the Surface, and that's in the single core test. But in the multi-core tests, the iPad takes over almost completely. Feel free to pause the video and check the results. I will post a link to the results in the description so you can go and check them one by one if you like. So what's the point of all this? The iPad proves to be dominant in hardware. Apple's M1 processor is a powerhouse that has no match in the tablet world, and it's loaded with iPadOS 15, which is tailored to show this power. So in my opinion, the iPad stands on the thin line between being a simple tablet or a beast of a laptop. It offers a simplified version of the MacBook in some way, but it's not a laptop, and it should not be. If I wanted a laptop, I would go and buy a laptop. But what I need is a tablet that can replace my laptop and be a tablet when I need it to be simple. On the other hand, the Surface 8 is just another laptop with a touch screen. It is loaded with the heavy Windows operating system, which contains a lot of bloatware and loads too many services that you don't know exist and you don't need anyways. Add to that the cooling fans and the kickstand that has as many features as this $1 tablet stand. So the conclusion is, if you can't find the programs you need in the App Store and you absolutely need Microsoft Windows to load your programs and do your thing, then the iPad is not for you. But then again, the Surface Pro 8 makes no sense at all. I mean, why pay so expensive for features you can have on any laptop that runs Windows for a much cheaper price? We all know that many computer brands did launch their versions of laptops with touch screens in the past. And in my opinion, this type of devices never got their fair share of the market was because of Windows operating system. And Surface Pro 8 is just another laptop with a touch screen that's pretending to be a simple tablet. Anyway, this was my opinion and that was it for today. Please let me know if you have a different opinion or if you agree with me in the comments down below. In the next episode, I'm gonna be talking about Christmas gifts and which is the best iPad to put under the tree for your partner, kids, parents, or maybe yourself. So please stay tuned, hit the like button, subscribe, go watch my old videos, and share to your social networks. That will help me grow my channel and keep up the hard work. Thank you very much for watching. This was Nibs. See you next time.